Hello friends, today we are going to do the practical on OSPF, that is open shortest path first, which will help us to find out the shortest path between source to destination. I'll do the connection. The device is already put on the window. As you can see, that is three routers, three switch and three PCs, all are generic devices. You can see the color is changing at PC and at the switch level because there is no need to configure the switch. So it will automatically do the connection between PC and the switch. The IP address is already provided to all the PCs. And the PCs are already configured by providing IP address, subnet mask, and default gateway. It is nothing but the IP address of the router. That is, it will always remain .1, that is .1. Accordingly, all the PCs were configured. All the pieces were configured. Function has been done. Up to the function using automatic use connection type table. Function has been done. Now I have to provide the IP address for individual routers as well. So the IP address for the router will be 192.168.2.1. For this router, IP address will be 192.168.3.1. For this router, IP address will be 192.168.4.1. For the network between individual routers, I will give you the network for this router is for this particular DC. For this side, I'll give 11.0.0.1, and for this side, I'll give 11.0.0.2. The network IP address for individual routers is provided. Now we will go for the configuration of the router. Fast Ethernet 0/0, fast Ethernet 0/0, fast Ethernet 0/0. Accordingly, we will do the configuration from serial cable. Fast Ethernet 0/0, go to the configuration, fast Ethernet 0/0. It will ask us for the IP address. The IP address for the system is, the router is 192.168.2.1. Submit all is accepted. We have to keep the port status on so the data packet can be transmitted accordingly. For the same serial cable 2/0, serial cable 2/0 for the same router, router that is router 0, we have to provide the address that is in network ID 10.0.0.1. Submit also will be appear. Port status, we have to keep it on. As the clock appears, we have to set the clock for the same. By default, clock rate is 64,000. The connection has been completed for this particular network. I'll go to the router number 2, go to the configuration, fast Ethernet. As you see, the fast Ethernet 0/0, the IP address is 192.168.3.1. So 192.168.3.1. Subnet mask will be provided. I click on port status on. As there is no clock for the serial 2/0, we don't suppose to set the timer. I'll go to the set serial cable. The IP address will be 10.0.0.2. Subnet mask will be appearing. Port status will be on. As there is no clock, so I don't need to set any clock here. Accordingly, for the same router, we have another clock, that is serial cable 3/0. The network is 11.0.0.1. go to the serial cable. This is already provided in the label, that is 11.0.0.1. So then possibly here you can see the clock appear. So we have to on the port, clock rate will be 64,000 as per default. Close it for this. I'll go to the next router, to the configuration. Configuration fast ethernet is provided. I'll go to the fast ethernet. This is 192.168.4.1. Fast port status on. Serial cable 2/0. I'll go to serial cable 2/0. IP address is 11.0.0.2. Submit mask and status on. Close this connection as we have done. The connection for all the PCs and all the routers, we have to define the areas as well. So providing the areas, as first of all define which area it is. This is belongs to area 1, this belongs to area area 0, and this network belongs to area. So we have three different areas, area 1, area 0 and area 2. For all the individual networks, we have to define it by configuring routers using CLI mode. So go to the, for the CLI mode, CLI for router 1 configuration is already given. For same router, that is command is router Ospf 1, command is accepted. Now we have to define the network as well. So network will be network, first network is the network ID for area 1 is, if the IP address is 192.168.0, default gateway is 192.168.2.1, then the network will be 192.168.2.0. So 192.168.2.0. Submit mask for the same is 0.0.0.255, and we have to define the area over here. So area 1 for this whole network. Network. Another network ID is available for the router as well as 10.0.0.1. So for this, the network will be 10.0.0.0, and the subnet mask for the same is 0.255.255.255. It will provide the area. Area will remain the same for this network as well. Set and the configuration for area 1. I'll go for the router number 2. Go to CLI mode. I'll go for again router OSPF 2. Enter again. We have to provide network. Network for this is 192.168.3.1, so the network ID for the same is 192.168.3.0. Subnet mask for the same is 0.0.0.255, and area for the same will is say 0. So area 0. Area 0, enter. The another network for the same is 10.0.0.2, that is 10.0.0.0. So network will be 10.0.0.0. The subnet mask for the same is 0.255.255.255. I have to define the area for the same is area. For this, the area will be 1 as it belongs to this particular area. For 192.168.1.3.0, the area will be 0. Enter. We have one more area connected, or one more network connected to this same router, that is 10 series and 11 series. The network for the same will be network 11.0.0.0. Subnet mask for the same will be 0.255.255.255, and for this area 2. Enter. Then the configuration for this router as well. Process will go for the last router. CLI mode. Again, OSPF, router. OSPF. Network. Network for the same will be 192.168.4.0. Subnet mask for the same is 0.0.0.255. Area is area 2. This is all. That is called as area 2. Area 2. Enter. Another network is. Network is 11 series 11.0.0.0 space subnet mask is 0.255.255.255 and area 2. Exit. The configuration for the all the three routers has been done properly. Now we will check whether our PDU can transmit from one device to another device. Share. We'll check. It's successful. Okay. From this PC to this PC. It's successful. From this PC to this PC. It's successful. So, we've done the configuration using, as we have done the configuration using OSPF protocol, we will check. So this is the IP route which are provided by the individual router to travel in a network to reach up to one destination. You can check the configuration or using the simulation which will help us to check the transmission of individual PDU. You can use the speed here. You can see the packets were moving from source to destination using the USB protocol. Data has been sent and the reply is received by source. Thank you so much. If you have any doubt, you can ask me for the same.